Hello engineers, in this video we are going to discuss about the difference between reciprocating pump and centrifugal pump. In our last videos we have discussed about the reciprocating pump, we have discussed about the centrifugal pump. There are so many videos about the centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump in the playlist of the core engineering. Now it is the time for the difference between to know about the difference between the reciprocating pump and centrifugal pump, right? So let's start the video with what is reciprocating pump. Already we have discussed about the reciprocating pump, right? We have gone through the detailed video about the centrifugal pump, about the reciprocating pump. Please watch that video as well. Now let's take the overview of the reciprocating pump, right? In our last videos also we have discussed about the reciprocating pump in details. I will recommend you that please watch that videos as well after this video, right? So if I talk about the overview of the reciprocating pump, so reciprocating pump is a positive displacement type pump, right? It is a positive displacement type pump. Okay, so in our last videos we have discussed about the what is the meaning of the positive displacement pump. If you classify the pump, so pump is mainly classified in the two group. The first one is rotodynamic pump, right? And the second one is simply, first one is rotodynamic pump and the second one is positive displacement type pump. Positive displacement type pump, right? So in the first we will discuss about the positive displacement type pump. Positive displacement type pump, right? So the positive displacement type pumps, what happens in this pump? We take the closed volume. Let's suppose this is my system. So what I'll do, we will take the closed volume, and in that closed volume, what we will do? We will change the boundary, right? What we will do? We will change the boundary, right? So as we will change the boundary, and if you have like studied about the thermodynamics, so what will happen? If you will compress the system, let's suppose there is the piston, right? There is the piston system you have arranged here. Now if you will compress this system, what will happen? The pressure will increase. If you will expand this system, the vacuum will create. That we will discuss in the upcoming slides as well as you can watch our previous videos, right? So that is the meaning of the positive displacement. Now if you are changing the boundary with the help of the reciprocating action like backward and forward motion, so that is the reciprocating pump, right? And if you are changing that boundary with the help of the rotary, okay, with the help of the rotary motion, okay, or rotary mechanism you can say, so that is the gear pump, okay, that is the rotary pump you can say, like gear pump, vane pump, lobe pump, right? So that is, we have written here, a reciprocating pump is a type of the positive displacement pump that includes the piston. It could be piston type pump, it could be plunger pump, or it could be diaphragm pump, right? And I would like to tell you that this piston, plunger and diaphragms are the heart of the reciprocating pump, right? Now it is often used where the small means a relatively small quantity of liquid is to be handled and where the delivery pressure is quite large. That we will discuss what is the meaning of it, right? Means mainly it is used where the Q is small, right? Your Q is small but you require the high head, right? Now in centrifugal pump, now in reciprocating pump, the chamber that traps the liquid is stationary. Okay, stationary cylinder, this one, okay, this is your chamber where you will trap the liquid, okay, because that is the closed volume you will take there, right? That will be your stationary cylinder that contains a piston or plunger, right? Now unmaintained, however, they can succumb to wear and tear. Means this is the, simply you can say, the disadvantage of this, because what you are doing here, you are simply changing the boundary with the help of the piston and plunger, so sometimes there is the problem of the wear and tear, right? So I hope now like there will be rough idea about the reciprocating pump you have, right? But if you want to know about the details about the reciprocating pump, please watch our previous videos. Now let's discuss about the centrifugal pump, right? Now let's discuss about the centrifugal pump. So centrifugal pump is the one of the widely used pump in the industry as well as in the domestic purpose. More than 90% of the pumps are used in the industry are the your centrifugal pump, right? So what are the centrifugal pump? Centrifugal pumps are the rotodynamic pumps, right? There we use the one, like simply you can say the rotary equipment, you can say that is the impeller that we will discuss. Now centrifugal pumps are the rotodynamic pump, right? So centrifugal pumps are used to transport fluids by the conversion of rotational kinetic energy to the your hydrodynamic energy of the fluid flow. Now what happens in the like centrifugal pump, there is the impeller, okay? So when the fluid goes into the eye of the impeller, the vacuum create there, okay? Because at that time your pressure is very less. So what happens that as the pressure difference create, so simply your liquid will go from pipe, from the suction pipe to the eye side, and here you can say, okay, in that region what happens that the area increases slightly. So as the area increases, your first of all, because there is the impeller, so it rotates, so your kinetic energy increases, right? So as the kinetic energy increases, and when what we are doing, we are increasing the area gradually. So as the area is increasing, so what happens that your kinetic energy reduced or pressure energy increase, okay? And the pressure energy increase, so what happens that your kinetic energy convert into the simply pressure energy. As your area increases, pressure increases and velocity decreases, right? Are you getting my point? Now the rotating part of the centrifugal pump is the impeller, that is also called the heart of the centrifugal pump, right? Now the rotational energy typically comes from the prime mover. Prime mover means you are simply your motor and engine, you can say, right? Means you will rotate the impeller. So how you will rotate? With the help of the prime mover, with the help of the motor, right? Now they are a subclass of the rotodynamic pump that we have already discussed, right? So now I hope you have the a basic clarity about the centrifugal pump and about the reciprocating pump. If you have any doubt, please let me in the comments box so that I could clarify your doubts, right? Now let's discuss about the what are the difference between the centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump. Okay, one by one we will take the every difference and we will understand that difference, that why this is the difference. Okay, so if I talk about the reciprocating pump, in reciprocating pump your discharge is fluctuating and pulsating, right? But in the case of the centrifugal pump, your discharge is continuous and smooth. Now it's time to understand it. Okay, means why it is happening. In the case of the reciprocating pump, what happens that as simply let's understand here, okay, this is your chamber, okay, this is your piston. Now what is happening here, simply you are, first of all you will expand the boundary, then you will compress the boundary. So what will happen that first your liquid will come, okay, and that time the discharge will not go from here, right? And when it will go backward, means when you will compress it, so what will happen that the suction valve will be closed and your discharge valve will be open. So it means that your discharge will not be continuous, it means that it will fluctuate, your discharge is fluctuate and there will be pulsation will create, means in the discharge side your pressure will not be smooth, okay, it will be like that, okay, that is called the pulsating. Okay, so to prevent our system from the pulsation, sometimes you will see that there is a damper we used, okay, for that to reduce the fluctuation and pulsating. We also use the double acting pump, okay. In that double acting pump, what happens that there are the two suction pipe, you can say, okay, and two discharge pipe. So at one time, when let's suppose your suction valve is open, so what will happen that the discharge, like when the suction valve will be open, so discharge valve will be open of the others, okay, and when the discharge valve will be closed of other, so its suction valve will be open. Ultimately its main purpose is that your suction and discharge will be continuous that time, okay. I'll also show you the picture here, right? And in the case of the centrifugal pump, simply that is continuous because here like the pulsation is not there, okay, as you will simply on the pump, so your discharge will be continuous. Are you getting my point, what I want to say? Now, in the case of the reciprocating pump, it does not need the priming, okay? But in the case of the centrifugal pump, it needs the priming. Now, you will say, sir, what is the priming? That we have already discussed in our previous videos. So, actually, priming is the, what happens that in the, if I talk about the centrifugal pump, so what happens that, simply, let's suppose, this is your centrifugal pump. Now it is taking a suction from the tank that is below. Okay. Now what happens that sometimes when it is standby and closed, so air traps within the suction side. Okay. Now it is usually now it doesn't like usually now this problem does not occur, which I haven't seen that, but sometimes we also like also face this problem. So what happens that at the suction side air comes, okay, when this air comes, so what happens that when we start the pump, so it doesn't load the or it doesn't pump the liquid, right? But right now what we are doing, simply we put the one NRV here, okay, so what happens that as we close the pump, so simply it traps the water, right? It simply traps the water here. So and we does not require the priming. And sometimes you will see that the most of the pumps, like most of the tanks in the refinery in fertilizer are above. So what happens that simply your pump side, let's suppose if this is your suction valve, so what happens that the liquid is completely filled till here and you doesn't require the priming. That is the self priming pump, right? So what is the priming basically? Priming is nothing but to remove the air and to fill the water there, okay, so that your pump simply can pump the liquid. Okay, now you will say, sir, why it doesn't require the priming in the reciprocating pump? Because when it will expand, so vacuum creates, let's suppose the air is there, but when it will compress, so it compress like that your discharge valve will be definitely open. Most of the cases it is open and your air will go to the like in the downstream or from the your discharge side, okay. But in the case of the centrifugal pump, it is not there, it is the impeller simply, so it will rotate, but here you are compressing the system, okay. So as you compress, area or the pressure increases, simply your NRV will be open, okay. In the case of the reciprocating pump, at the suction side as well as at the discharge side, both there will be NRV, right? But in that case, there will be in the, like in the discharge side, there will be wall, okay, there will be wall and then there will be NRV, right? The case could be different as well, but most of the time it is the case. Now in the reciprocating pump, for safety purpose, PSV is required in the reciprocating pump at discharge side. Okay, what is the meaning of it? We will discuss that as well. Okay, and in centrifugal pump, for internal safety of the pump, okay, for internal part safety purpose, in centrifugal pump, the strainer is required at the suction side, right? So let's discuss about the reciprocating pump first. So what happens that at the reciprocating pump, as I have already told you that the pulsation is there, right? And some pulsation is there, fluctuation is there, okay? When you take the changeover of the reciprocating pump, so what happens that simply if you consider one case, this is your system, okay, and this is your piston, and simply what you are doing in the reciprocating pump case, there is the rotary motion, there is the radial motion, simply you can say. But here what is happening that, let's suppose there is the liquid, okay, there is the liquid. Now if you will compress this liquid, right, if you will compress this liquid, so your pressure will be suit very fast. Your pressure will suit very, very fast. Okay. That's why I already told you that it is used for the high head, right? When you will compress it slightly, when your piston will be come here, so your pressure will be increased very slowly. But when it will come here, your pressure will be suit very fast. Are you getting my point? So let's suppose while the changeover, you didn't on or you didn't open the discharge valve, so what will happen that simply your discharge side, discharge pipe could be brushed up, right? So for the pump safety, for the pipe safety, discharge pipe safety, what we do, we use the discharge PSV, we use the PSV at the discharge side, right? Let's suppose you are taking the changeover or you are starting the reciprocating pump. So let's suppose if you haven't opened the discharge valve, so your PSV will be pop up. Okay, and in other cases as well, let's suppose the pressure shoot up, so simply your PSV will be pop up. Okay, it could be also happen in the centrifugal pump. Okay, that case also you can use the PSV at the discharge side. Even I have also seen the PSV at the suction side as well. Okay, that is the different case, that is the requirement of the client. Okay, and it depends on the so many criteria, right? And in the case of the centrifugal pump, mainly the for the safety point of view, the strainer is used. Okay, at the suction side, at the suction side of the pump, there will be strainer. Okay, now that strainer is used to remove the foreign particles from the fluid. Okay, so that the dust or the foreign particles couldn't go into the impeller or casing, it could damage that. Okay, that's why we use the Y type strainer, bucket type strainer, conical type strainer, straight type strainer. That is the different thing, but that we use. Are you getting my point? Okay, I hope you are enjoying this video. Okay, and if you are liking this video, simply like our video, share our video with your friends. Okay, if you have any doubts, please let me in the comments box. It gives us the motivation that yes, you are learning. Okay, you are learning something new, and that also gives us the motivation that we continue the series, right? Now if I talk about the reciprocating pump, so as if you will see in the reciprocating pump, there is the cylinder, there is the piston is there, there is the PSV. Okay, so the maintenance cost of the reciprocating pump is large or more, or in the case of the centrifugal pump, the maintenance cost is less, right? In mainly I have seen that in the centrifugal pump, only strainer cleaning we do. Okay, there is the scheduled maintenance also we do for the pump, but that time also we only replace the oil. Okay, sometimes if there is some leakage, so that we attend, but most of the time what I have seen, only the cleaning of the your strainer. Okay, that the, because of the fluid. Okay, it also depends on the fluids. Okay, fluid to fluid, if the fluid will be more viscous, more foreign particles will be there, so it will be like you, the frequency will be high, but if it is not there, so frequency will be low. But mainly what I have seen that in the centrifugal pump, the strainer cleaning. But if there is the some problems occurs, okay, in the reciprocating pump, so that is the large. Like sometimes the plunger fails, sometimes the sealing fails, so that is the little bit complex. Okay, and the construction also, if I talk about the construction point of view, that we will also discuss later. In the construction point of view as well, the reciprocating pump is complex as compared to the centrifugal pump. Now in the reciprocating pump, the flow rate is constant with a change in pressure. Why the flow rate is constant? Simply you will see here what we do. As we expand the system and as we compress the system, so your liquid will go from the discharge side. Okay, just make the pump here as well, right? This is your piston, right? So it will go from here, and the, let's suppose the suction from here, and there is the NRV, right? So why we are saying this is the flow rate is constant here, because as you will compress it, okay, before that there is the one thing, that is the stroke volume into RPM, right? That is the very very important thing when we are discussing about the flow rate and the capacity, right? Simply when you compress it, so what will happen, that your liquid will go like here. Okay, here doesn't like your flow will be constant, and that's why you will see that it is mainly used for the metering purpose. And we also say that these pumps are the your dosing pump. Okay, mainly you will see that at the dosing purpose reciprocating pumps are used, because these are the your constant or precise flow rate is there, right? Because as you will compress it, the RPM is fixed here, the stroke volume is fixed here. Okay, the volume is fixed here. Are you getting my point? And the RPM you can adjust. So as you will adjust the RPM at one point, so simply your flow rate will be constant there, right? But in the case of the centrifugal pump, your flow rate is vary as the pressure change. as the pressure change. Why we are, as we were saying about it, so simply, if you will, like, let's suppose at this point your pressure change, right? In the case of the reciprocating pump, let's suppose I just change the color here. Simply at this point, let's suppose as the your pressure reduces, so it will not impact at the your flow, okay? It will also go here. Why? Because you are simply compressing the system. But in the case of the centrifugal pump, it doesn't do here. What happens that simply here, what happens that let's suppose at the discharge side there is the your one control valve, okay? So let's suppose if it is open 40% and it is open at the 80%, okay? That is the two scenario. So what will happen that at the 40%, when it will be 40%, the pressure drop will be high, okay? Means your, like, pressure drop will be high, but when you will open it 80%, the pressure drop will be low as compared to this. So what will happen that the resistance will become and your liquid will be go more, because when you will provide the more area, so it will go more, right? Are you getting my point, what I want to say? Because here you are providing the more path in the case of the centrifugal pump here, but in the case of the reciprocating pump, it is not there, okay? Are you getting my point, what I want to say? So flow rate is changes as you change the pressure, right? I hope you are getting this, right? Because in the reciprocating pump, simply when you will compress the system, it will go away, means your fluid will go simply, okay? The, let's suppose if there is the pressure drop, it doesn't, like, there is nothing like that, okay? Means it will not impact your downstream more, right? Some fluctuation it could be there, but most of the time that is the concept, right? And there could be like other, you can say simply the requirement, all we can say, or some other facilities as well, like the recycle, you can say, and sometimes there is the NR, like the control valve as well, okay? Mainly there will be the pressure control valve, mainly there will be the pressure control valve, but in this case there will be flow control valve, right? Flow control valve. I hope you are getting what I want to say, right? Please think it logically. Next, the reciprocating pump is complicated in operation, that we have already discussed, because there is the piston arrangement, okay, that go backward and forward. So the reciprocating pump is complicated in operation and with much noise. If you will see the reciprocating pump in our industry, so that creates the noise, okay, that creates the more noise, right? But in the case of the centrifugal pump, sometimes you will see that the centrifugal pump doesn't create the noise, okay? The high precise pump, you will say, that is the little bit costly as well, but in the case of the centrifugal pump, it creates the less noise, okay? That is also in operation also, that is the smooth. Why that is smooth? Because there is simply one impeller, it rotates and your kinetic energy converted into the pressure energy. Now next, that if cost point of view, if I say, let's suppose the flow rate is C, right? For both cases, if this centrifugal pump is $1 lakh, so it would be around $3 lakh. Are you getting my point? So that is the difference between the with respect to cost point of view, this is the difference between the reciprocating pump and the centrifugal pump, right? That's personally, why? Because the centrifugal pump is simple in construction, but the reciprocating pump, there is the complexity is there, right? Now in the reciprocating pump, there is the air vessel or damper is required, but in the case of the centrifugal pump, it doesn't require. Why the damper is required? At the suction side, at the discharge side, why the damper is required? Because of the pulsation, okay? So what the damper do? Simply it reduces the pulsation. Why? Because already there is the fluid is already stored there, okay? Sometimes in the case of the ammonia, which I have seen, the liquid ammonia, the already we have, like, there is the your liquid is already there, and at the top what we do, there is the steam jacketing, so the pressure is already created there. So as the pressure drop happens, simply it pushes the liquid, okay, that go the downstream and everything is normalized, right? Now let's see the more difference between the reciprocating pump and the centrifugal pump, okay? The reciprocating pump is complicated in constructions, okay, a more number of the spare parts is here, okay. In this case, the torque is uniform. In the case of the centrifugal pump, simple in construction, less number of spare parts. In the case of the centrifugal pump, only impeller is there, okay, most simply impeller and casing. But in the case of the reciprocating pump, that is, I am taking the overview, right? In the case of the reciprocating pump, piston is there, chamber is there, crank rod is there, right? The crankcase is there, right? Then the prime mover, that will be in the both case, there will be prime mover. But the reciprocating pumps are little bit complex in construction. In reciprocating pump handles a small quantity of liquid. Most of the time you will see that the reciprocating pumps are favorable where the small Q is required and high head is required, because as you will compress the system, your pressure shoot up very fast, right? That's why sometimes it is also called the what, high head pump and constant flow pump, that we called. But if you will see the pump performance curve, let's discuss about it as well, okay. Pump performance curve is plotted between the head versus Q, right? And before that, let's discuss about the centrifugal pump. Centrifugal pump handles a large quantity of liquids or fluids. That's why the centrifugal pump is called the high volume pump. Centrifugal pump is called the high volume pump, right? Now if you will see the pump performance curve of the centrifugal pump, so it will be like that, okay. And where we operate, we mainly operate here, okay. So in that case, you can simply see here, this is the your high volume, means simply this is the constant head pump, okay. This is your constant head pump, means when the constant head will be required, we use the centrifugal pump. But when the constant flow is required, that time we will use the reciprocating pump. And in the case of the here, simply you can see, as you are changing the flow, head is almost constant, right? But in the case of the reciprocating pump, if you will see the performance curve, so it is like that. It goes like that, but mainly we consider here. So you will see that your flow is constant, right? But head is changing. That is very, very important point, okay? Pump, if you know about how to read the pump performance curve, I could simply say that you know everything about the pump. You can simply size the pump, right? Now, next thing is that reciprocating pump cannot handle the dirty water. That personally I have seen, but in the case of the centrifugal pump, it can handle the dirty water. Simply what you have to do, at the suction side, you can use the your strainer. I have also seen the centrifugal pump as well for the dirty water, but most of the time we do not prefer it, okay. You can also use the strainer here as well, okay. That is also I have seen in the liquid ammonia line. There was the high capacity reciprocating pump and there was the suction, there was the strainer at the suction as well as at the discharge side, but mainly it cannot handle the dirty water, right? And as the complicated this one, okay, large as well, it one, so heavy foundation is required, because the more noise is there, more vibration is there, so most of the time the foundation is heavy is here, right? But in the case of the centrifugal pump, the foundation is simple, right? Now reciprocating pump has a low efficiency and the centrifugal pump has a high efficiency. This is a general point of view, right? And if you can simply say, sir, in our industry there is the one reciprocating pump that has the this like X efficiency, and there is the centrifugal pump, but it has a Y efficiency, and the X efficiency is more than the Y efficiency, so I will simply say you that please see the requirement. What is the flow rate? What is the head? Okay, that is also we must consider. Now there I would like to tell you also one thing, that the power is depend on, if you will simply see the power, what is that? That is rho Q G H, okay. If you will multiply the efficiency there, so the power will come. Same you can find the efficiency here. In the case of the centrifugal pump, it will also same. Okay, the formula will be same, rho q g h. And right now we have studied that in the case of the centrifugal pump, okay, in the case of the centrifugal pump, if you see here, so as the q increases, as q increases, your power will be increased. Are you getting my point, what I want to say, right? And power is increasing here, right? Same in here, you will see that in the reciprocating pump, as your head increases, because q is constant here, so it depends, the power is depend on the head. If you will increase the head, power will increase. If you will increase the flow rate, your power will increase. This is, you must know about it, okay? For the efficiency point of view, for the power point of view, that point is very, very important. In your reciprocating pump, your power depends on the head. In centrifugal pump, it depends on the flow rate, right? And in the case of the reciprocating pump, this one needs a large floor area. But in your centrifugal pump, it doesn't need a large floor area, right? And this is also depends on the requirement to requirement, and also the your capacity to capacity, right? Now in this case, your torque is not uniform, but in this case your torque is uniform, okay? Can you please let me in the comments box that what is the meaning of this, okay? Please ignore this one, okay? Can you please let me in the comments box that what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of the torque here? Okay, how that crank rod, prime mover is connected with together. Okay, what is the meaning of the torque here? That is very, very important. And in the case of the centrifugal pump also, what is the meaning of this? Because I have seen that students are so much confused with this. This is little bit, you can say, the advanced thing that I am saying, because you don't require this, right, to know about the pump. But if you want to go much deeper, please understand this as well, right? We have already discussed about this. This is used where small q and high head is required, that we have already discussed. Same in the case of the centrifugal pump, it is used where high discharge and smaller head is required, right? Now this is your homework, that please let me in the comments box that like if you are using the reciprocating pump in your industry, that what is the head is there, okay, what is the q is of that pump, and same for the centrifugal pump, what is the head and what is the q flow rate is there, right? Now we have already discussed about that the reciprocating pump is an example of the positive displacement pump, and your centrifugal pump is the rotodynamic pump, right? So simply, if you see here, in the case of the reciprocating pump, this is the piston that we have already discussed. This is your delivery pipe, okay? That what I was saying, why the PSV is used here. Let's suppose if there is the NRV, and let's suppose if there is the wall, right? And you didn't open this wall. So what will happen, that when it will compress, simply this NRV will open because of the pressure, but this is closed. So what happened, that it could be brushed up. So what you will do, you will simply use here one PSV, you will use here, right? PSV will use here. Are you getting my point? The one thing. Second thing is that same, these are the NRV type wall. So as the vacuum will create here, when you will expand the system, it will open. And when you will go backward, okay, when you will go forward, simply when you will compress the system, this will open because of the pressure and it will close, right? This is your crank rod, this is your crank. Now this is your triplex type pump. This is your triplex type pump, means there is the three plunger. This is your piston type pump that we have already discussed, right? Now if you have any doubt in this video, simply let me in the comments box, okay? I'll definitely clear your doubt as soon as possible, and that also gives us the motivation to make more and more videos, right? So I am the process engineer by profession, so I will definitely try to clear your doubt, okay? By logically, please understand it. That is the very, very important video with respect to the industry point of view. That video is very, very important for you. So that's all for the today's video. If you have any doubt, please let me in the comments box. Like our video, share our video with your friends and in group. right? Subscribe our YouTube channel, press the bell icon so that you could get the latest notification. So thanks for the today's video. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning.